Hello guys, so today we are going to discuss some important questions on the topic Securities Appellate Tribunal, which is also called SAT. So this topic is very important for your SEBI grade examination. So friends, do subscribe to our channel if you like this video. So let's begin. So this is the first question. Section 15N of the SEBI Act 1992, it deals with tenure of presiding officer and other members. So basically in Securities Appellate Tribunal, there is a presiding officer and then there are technical members and judicial members, right? So presiding officer, technical members and judicial members. So section 15N, it deals with the tenure or term of presiding officer and these members. So for how long they are appointed in the office. So this section deals with their tenure. Now you are given some statements. You have to tell which is the incorrect out of these four. So the first, presiding officer and every other member are appointed for a term of 5 years. So this statement is right, because as per section 15N, presiding officer and members are appointed for a term of 5 years. Now next statement, statement B, presiding officer and members are eligible for reappointment for another term of maximum 5 years. So basically section 15N says that presiding officer and members can be reappointed for one more term of 5 years. So basically 5 plus 5, so maximum for 10 years. Presiding officer and members can be appointed for maximum 10 years, not more than that, right? Now statement C, the maximum age limit for presiding officer is 65 years, after which they cannot hold office. Now here I would like to tell you that Finance Act 2017. So what is the Finance Act? So Finance Act is basically an act which introduces changes or amendments in various acts like Income Tax Act, Excise, Service Tax, Custom, SEBI Act, Depositories Act, Securities Contract Act. So this act introduces changes in these acts, right? So Finance Act of 2017, it made amendments to this section 15N also. So earlier, the maximum age limit for presiding officer used to be 68 years and for other members it used to be 62 years. But after this amendment, the age limit has been increased to 70 years for both, right? So these limits have been changed and now it is 70 years for both presiding officers as well as judicial and technical members. So 65 years, so this is wrong. So statement C is wrong, it is not 65, it is 70 years. And statement number D, the maximum age limit for members is 70 years, after which they cannot hold office. So this is right. It has been increased from 62 to 70. So this is right. Now moving on, question number 2. Securities Appellate Tribunal is the authority for appeals in the securities market. Right. The presiding officer of SAT is appointed by. Now this question is asking you about the manner of appointment. So section 15M of SEBI Act 1992, it deals with the manner of appointment of presiding officer and members. So this section was amended by the Finance Act of 2017, right? So it says that presiding officer and judicial member, so both of these will be appointed by the central government in consultation with the Chief Justice of India. So central government in consultation with the Chief Justice of India. So option B here is correct, government of India. So the central government will appoint the presiding officer, right? But for technical members, they are appointed by a committee which comprises of the presiding officer and various secretaries of the government. Now moving on, next question, question 3. Which of the below mentioned statements are incorrect with regard to SAT? So there are some statements given to you. These statements are related to the procedure and powers of SAT. The procedure and powers of SAT. So section 15U of SEBI Act 1992, it deals with the power and procedure of Securities Appellate Tribunal. So first statement, the Securities Appellate Tribunal shall not be bound by the procedure laid down by the Code of Civil Procedure, but shall be guided by the principles of natural justice. This statement is correct, because section 15U, it says that SAT is not bound by Code of Civil Procedure, but it is guided by the principles of natural justice. So according to the principles of natural justice, it has to operate. So it does not need to follow the Code of Civil Procedure. Now next statement, statement 2, Every proceeding before the Securities Appellate Tribunal shall be deemed to be a judicial proceeding. So this statement is also correct, because you must know that any proceeding before any tribunal is deemed to be a judicial proceeding, because a tribunal is a quasi-judicial body. A quasi-judicial body. So quasi-judicial body basically means that it is not a court, but it can pass orders and it can pass decisions. So it has powers of passing decisions, but it is not exactly a court, because a court can give judgments on any matter, but a tribunal or a quasi-judicial body, they can impose laws on a specific administrative agency, not on all matters. So we have SAT for SEBI, we have Income Tax Appellate Tribunal for income tax authorities, we have NGT who looks into the matters related to environment. So these tribunals are set up for specific purpose. So statement 2 is correct. Statement 3, any person aggrieved by any decision or order of SAT can file an appeal to the High Court within 60 days from the date of communication of the decision or order of SAT. So statement number 3 is incorrect. Why? Because an appeal can be filed before Supreme Court, right? Not before High Court. Although the number of days, 60 days, the time period is here, right? But appeal can be filed before Supreme Court and not High Court. So this statement is incorrect. Statement 3 is incorrect. Also, the Supreme Court can extend this period of 60 days by another 60 days if it feels that there was sufficient reason for not filing the appeal within 60 days, right? And now statement 4. This is also related to section 15D. So 15D is basically related to the appeal process, right? So the appeal process or the appeal procedure. So statement 4, appeal filed before SAT shall be disposed of within 6 months from the date of receipt of the appeal. So this statement is right. So basically, I'll explain you the appeal process in a brief. So what happens? So if a person is not satisfied with the order of SEBI or PFRDA, the Pension Fund Regulatory Authority, or IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory Authority. So appeal can be filed against any of the three. So if a person is not satisfied or aggrieved by the decision of these authorities, then the person can file appeal before SAT within 45 days. Within 45 days. And also SAT is required to dispose the application within 6 months. SAT is required to dispose the application within 6 months. But if a person is not satisfied with the decision of SAT also, then an appeal can be filed before Supreme Court within 60 days. So here it was 45 days. For Supreme Court it is 60 days, right? So this is the procedure basically of filing an appeal. So in this question, as we have seen, statement 3 was the only statement which was incorrect. So the correct option is C, statement 3. Now moving on. Now before discussing question 4, I would like to tell you that we regularly post questions and conduct quiz on our Telegram group. We also share important and relevant information on that group. So make sure that you join that group. The link of the group is given in the description section below. Now question 4. Currently, SAT has only a single bench that has jurisdiction all over the country. Where does the bench of SAT sit? Now, I must tell you that currently SAT has a single branch that is in Mumbai, but it has jurisdiction all over India. So it can hear cases from all over India, right? But currently SAT is under-equipped because it needs more manpower, more members, and it needs more benches. So recently there were discussions of setting up a bench in Delhi also, which will cater to North and Northeastern states, but this has not been implemented yet. So currently only a single bench is operating in Mumbai, but there are a lot of pending cases before SAT. So it is in a dire need of more manpower and more benches. Now moving to question number 5, which of the following statements are incorrect with respect to SAT? So you are given 3 statements. You have to tell which of them are correct and which are incorrect. So first of all, statement 1, SAT is a statutory body established under the provisions of section 15K of the SEBI Act. So this statement is right because section 15K empowers the central government to set up tribunal, right? So it is established under section 15K. So section 15K to section 15Z. So these are sections of SEBI Act 1992. So these sections deal with the establishment, jurisdiction, authority, and procedure of appellate tribunal, security appellate tribunal, right? Now statement 2, apart from SEBI, SAT can also hear appeals against orders of PFRDA, IRDAI and RBI. So first of all, what is PFRDA? So PFRDA, it is Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority. Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority. So it is the regulator of pension funds, right? Like we have SEBI, which is the regulator of securities market. Likewise, PFRDA is the regulator of pension funds. And what is IRDAI? IRDAI is Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. So it is a regulator of insurance. So since 2015, SAT is also hearing appeals against PFRDA and IRDAI, but it cannot hear appeals against RBI. So statement 2 is incorrect, because it cannot hear appeals against RBI. It can hear appeals against SEBI, PFRDA and IRDAI. And statement 3, SAT is a quasi-judicial body. So this statement is right, as we have just discussed. SAT is a tribunal, right? And tribunal is a quasi-judicial body. Why quasi-judicial? Because it can pass orders, it can pass decisions, it can pass rulings, but it is not a court. So it is not exactly a high court or a supreme court, but it can pass rulings. So it is a quasi-judicial. Quasi means semi. So only statement 2 is incorrect, right? So correct option is C, only statement 2. Now moving on, question number 6. Section 15L of the SEBI Act 1992 deals with the composition of Securities Appellate Tribunal. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to composition? So as you know, Finance Act 2017 was passed, right? So before Finance Act was passed, earlier SAT used to comprise of 3 members. So one presiding officer and 2 other members, right? But after the passage of Finance Act, Section 15L was amended. So amendments were made in the section. Now the composition is one presiding officer and judicial and technical members, but their number are not specified. So the number may be specified by the central government. So now the members are classified into 2, judicial and technical. Before the Finance Act, there was no such classification, but now members are classified into judicial members and technical members. So judicial members are those who have knowledge about various laws and who have served as a judge in High Court. But technical members are those who have experience in the securities market or who have done work in the fields of depository, derivatives, insurance, etc. Right? So let us see. Statement 1. Securities Appellate Tribunal shall consist of a presiding officer and such number of judicial and technical members as the central government may determine. So this statement is right. Statement 2. The benches of SAT shall ordinarily sit at Mumbai and may also sit at such other places as the central government may, in consultation with presiding officers, notify. So statement 2 is also correct. Why? Because currently, as I have already told you, SAT is operating through a single bench only, which sits in Mumbai. But Section 15L empowers the central government to set up more benches in consultation with presiding officer, but currently they are sitting only in Mumbai. So statement 2 is correct. And statement 3, minimum 4 members are required to form quorum. Now I will explain this statement. So basically, SAT makes ruling through a bench. So Section 15L says that a bench shall comprise of a presiding officer and at least one judicial member and at least one technical member. So this must be the composition of a bench. So accordingly, we need minimum 3 members in a bench. So 3 members are needed to form a quorum. So not 4. So statement 3 is incorrect. So we can see only statement 3 is incorrect. So correct option is D, only statement 3. Now next question, question 7. So the answer to this question, I will not tell you. This is for you. So you must specify the answer in the comment section below, and then I'll tell you what is the correct answer. So the question says, any person who is aggrieved by any decision or order of the Securities Appellate Tribunal may file an appeal to which of the below mentioned authorities? So actually, I have already given you the answer of this question indirectly. So this is a very straightforward question. I hope that most of you will answer this question correctly. So your options are Supreme Court, Chief Justice of India, Ministry of Corporate Affairs and SEBI. So write your answers in the comment section below. Also guys, if you learned something new from this video, then make sure that you hit the subscribe button to get more updates and notifications.